Hey, this is Winfred. In this video, I'm going to analyze what this Goguryeo word means. It's pronounced 약지도치, which was the name of a walled town that is now called, it's somewhere in 경기도, 장단군 송림현. It's a small village near North Korean border. Just by looking at this word, 약지도치 is certainly a pure Korean pronunciation, of a word written in Hanja. My job is to find out what it was actually pronounced without the influence of Hanja. Let's get going. My initial thought was, is this some kind of an animal or plant name? I thought this because nearby this ancient town was a village named Tosangun, which means Rabbit Mountain Village. And to somewhere in the east was a village named Yashime, which means Fox Lakeside. There was also a town called a Pig Foot. A Pig Foot! What I'm saying is that there were quite few villages or towns that were named after animals in the ancient times. So logically, 약지도치 could have been also an animal name. Let's take a look at these last two characters. The moment I saw these, it was none other than 도지 or 두지. In Middle Korean, 두지 was pronounced as 두디. And this 치 seems to be an aspirated consonant. Thus, there could have been a hidden consonant right underneath 두, which should be t or tigut. Because if you combine tigut and e in Korean, it becomes palatalized to some degree. Therefore, it becomes ch or chi. The first letter would have been pronounced as just like do or do in ancient times, so no need to fret over. So that was easy. Now let's take a look at the second word. This should be a no-brainer as well. In Shilan language, this character was either pronounced s, z, or z. This last triangle character in Hangul is called banjiot, literally meaning a lightweight S sound or half S sound. It sounds like Z as in zoo. This is now obsolete in modern Korean. Anyways, this character could have been pronounced as Shi, Ji, Chi on its own. This last character is very tricky. Try to follow along as best as you can. In Sino-Korean, that is, if I read this in Chinese as a Korean person pronouncing it, it is Yak. Yak. There is rarely a lengthy word that starts with Yak in Korean. So I need to look at the pure Korean pronunciation, not Sino-Korean pronunciation. In Samguksagi, a historical text on the three kingdoms of Korea, there was a walled town in Goguryeo which was called Buyeoseong, but it was also called Buyakseong. Here, the record is telling me that the character Yak was phonetically similar to Yeo. Just a side note, when I say phonetically similar, it means pure Korean phonology, not Sino-Korean phonology, okay? As I said before, ancient Koreans just merely borrowed Chinese characters on a whim to fit their own pure Korean pronunciation, so one cannot rely heavily on Sino-Korean pronunciation of that character. Therefore, it is necessary to look at the variations in pure Korean pronunciation of a single Hanja character. Having said that, these two characters are replaceable, meaning they can be used interchangeably. One pronunciation is cut. Another pronunciation, which can be gleaned from hyangchao, basically another way of saying pure Korean pronunciation, is da, do, de, do, da. Let's simplify as ga and do. Okay, we now have a final set of combination of words here. All we need to do is just read them. The first array is pronounced 같이.이. In old Korean pronunciation, it would have been 거슴.이. In modern Korean, a hedgehog is called 고슴도치. The second array is pronounced 두디지. That light sky blue highlighted inner focalic consonant could have been a consonant to indicate that there was a stress in the character that followed immediately after it, but probably went away due to a diachronic process. That is, time got rid of it. In modern Korean, a mole is called 두더지 because it is digging through a pile of trash or mound of some objects. In terms of plant, it could have meant 소나무, a pine tree which is found abundant in Korea. The leaves of a pine tree are sharp and thin like a needle. Needle in modern Korean is either 비늘 or 가시. A tree that has a lot of needle looking like leaves might have been called 가시도친 나무. So that's all for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye for now.